Going to have something right from the very beginning of the Baltimore Catechism, our basic catechism, basic foundation for our whole faith, our purpose in life, which is to know, love, and serve God. Now, it's human nature that we will not willingly serve a God whom we do not love, and we will not love a God we do not know. So here's the thing. I don't love anybody in Borneo because I don't know anyone in Borneo. So don't get up in the morning with any particular inclination or inspiration to serve anyone in Borneo. But if I do not wake up in the morning with an inclination and an inspiration to serve Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, then Houston, we got a problem. And the problem in the world today, as it was in Noah's day, and as it was in Abraham, Lot, and Sodom and Gomorrah's day, as it was as Jesus warned us it would be, is that there are way too many people who don't know the first thing about Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So truth be told, they do not love Him. And so we can see in the many godless politicians out there, in the godless educational system, in the godlessness of so many sheeples, they most definitely are not serving Him. They are not fulfilling their purpose in life to know, to love, and to serve God. Oh, you're just being political. Father Altman's too political. Politics has no place in the Catholic Church. Baloney. Pope Benedict XVI said, "The church is not a political power, it's not a party, but it is, at least it's supposed to be, it is a moral power. Therefore, since politics fundamentally should be a moral enterprise, the church, in this sense, has something to say about politics. Therefore, when politics and politicians act in an immoral way, we most certainly do have the duty and the obligation to speak up and speak up about it." When they complain, they say, "Hey, you're a bunch of hypocrites." Capital H. Guess who was just a premier speaker at the Democratic National Convention? None other than the hyper-confusion-spreading heretic James Martin, S.J. Well, I guess it's okay for James Martin to spout off for the Democrats on their national stage, but God forbid a priest speak out against their godless platform. Here's a memo to clueless baptized Catholics out there. You cannot be Catholic and be a Democrat, period. Their party platform absolutely is against everything the Catholic Church teaches. So just quit pretending that you're Catholic and vote Democrat. Repent of your support of that party and its platform or face the fires of hell. Yes, Virginia, there is a hell. There's a well-known cleric who seems to be putting out there that, oh, hell is an empty place. Sorry, buddy. It's not what Jesus said. Jesus said many are going to choose that broad road to destruction. Only a few are going to choose the narrow, very difficult road to the narrow gate to heaven. There will be 60 million in counting aborted babies standing at the gates of heaven barring your Democrat entrance, and nothing you can say will ever excuse you for your direct or indirect support of that diabolical agenda here in the end. It's too bad there's so many gutless cowards in the clergy who refuse to speak up and speak out on that truth and make it crystal clear. There should be no confusion among any Catholic. CV, at the end of the day, I do research. And I actually researched all the data, the information, I crunched the numbers, and finally came up with a pretty close approximate total of how many Catholics voted for Obama in 2008 and 2012. Zero. Wrap your minds around that, dear family. There were a lot of pretenders, a lot of imposters, a lot of people masquerading as Catholics, laity and clergy alike. There were zero faithful Catholics who voted for that godless politician who had the audacity to blaspheme and say, "God bless Planned Parenthood, the most racist organization on the face of this planet, founded to wipe out black babies." Wilton Gregory, figure it out. So back to the hypocrisy of those who complain I'm too political. The complainers, the hypocrites, by the way, always are from the left, both laity and clergy alike. In addition to thinking it's a-okay for James Martin to prance up onto the Democrats' national stage, certain of the hierarchy think nothing about ripping into Donald Trump because somehow Trump has differing views about national sovereignty and national borders. No problem about stuffing things like the climate change hoax into the political arena, into the Catholic Church. Well, here in the U.S., in addition to James Martin, the St. Anthony Messenger has two major political statements. One against Trump in support of DACA, which means criminal illegal aliens, and the other supporting the Southern Poverty Law Center, which seems to be one of the most godless, communist, anti-American, left-wing radical organizations in the United States. And again, one ripping on Trump and supporting Wilton Gregory's horrific attack on the one best pro-life president and his Catholic wife. You know, as a bishop recently said to me, it's no wonder the faithful have lost confidence in the bishops because so many of them did such a horrible job on the scandal. And still to this day, don't say anything about the worst miscreants. Oh, but they sure will get all over a priest instantly who simply speaks the truth. Oh, yes, dear family, they are quick as lightning when they want to be to silence any priest who dares to step out of line. I mean, do you really wonder why ordinary priests do not speak up? It's out of fear, dear family. Fear. Shame on the hierarchy who covers up truth through a conspiracy of fear. Listen, if there wasn't truth spoken, nobody, but nobody, would be listening to me for 2 seconds. And if all that is accomplished by speaking up is to let the proud and arrogant in the hierarchy realize that the faithful are suspicious and they have good reason, and that they need to straighten up and straighten out this mess that they created or they continued before they lose yet more faithful to the fastest growing denomination in the United States, ex-Catholics, then job accomplished. But, dear family, there is truth spoken, and it continues to slap faithful Catholics in the faith when Notre Dame gives Obama an honorary doctorate, when James Martin takes the national stage for the Democrats, and when a pro-life president gets ripped on by an archbishop of the Catholic Church, who then, within days, urges his priests to go all political and join hands with the Marxist protesters, Black Lives Matter. Dear family, it is basic to our salvation that we must, that our purpose in life is to know, love, and serve God. We have a duty and an obligation to know Him so that we love Him, so that we serve Him unto martyrdom, red or white. And it is human nature that we will not willingly serve a God whom we do not love, and we will not love a God we do not know. And the reason why we are seeing the signs of the times, the cataclysm that's approaching, that we have been warned about, our Blessed Mother warned us about it. The reason why we're seeing this is that way too many people do not know God through their most grievous fault. And too many shepherds of the church haven't taught them. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.